Good evening. Sorry. As soon as I said good evening, someone sent me a message. Right. Well, I spent a few hours with Mum in town this morning. Just had a wander around the charity shops, and I've got that box up there for £2. And I'll show you what's in that in a bit. Providing the battery lasts on the camera. If it doesn't, I'll just charge it, so... either way, I'll show you. I had a friend pop up this afternoon. I sorted the front gears out on his bike. Basically, what had happened... the gear cable had slackened off. Hang on a minute. Yep. Flip that round. There we go. Yeah, the gear cable had slackened off. And, there's just so much gunk and dirt gotten into the front derailleur, it just wouldn't spring back. So I cleaned it all out, gave it an oil, readjusted the derailleur a little bit, pulled the gear cable tight, and just moved it up and down to work the oil into all the joints, and that fixed the problem. Easy. He does need a new sealed bottom bracket, because that one has already gone. I can't believe it, because it weren't that many months ago. It might have been 6 months ago at least I put that in there. But he does go on very long bike rides almost daily. So I know for a fact it's covered a lot of miles. Although I still think that should have lasted longer than that. Oh, it's all dark. Right. Okay, so, note to self, stay this way. Oh, pardon me. Yeah, the other thing I've been doing is, I've located a few replacement parts for the Silver Fox. Hopefully that'll be a job for tomorrow, so I've got a hair in my... That's what I was trying to lick and get rid of. Yeah, I'm going to try and get onto that tomorrow. But this afternoon I thought I'd sort the trailer bike out, which is over there somewhere. Are we on? Are we in view? Yeah, we're in view. The back wheel I had in it had a buckle in it, so I've taken that out. I've changed the front forks. The ones I've put in there are triple clamp, and they actually fit a lot better. So, and they feel a lot better to steer with, so I've done that and changed the front wheel. My lips keep going dry, that's why I keep going like that. Keep drying out when I'm talking, which is annoying. Anyway, I was going to put in that back wheel down there, but the gap between the freewheel and the frame, far too big. And I can't adjust the axle, which is all I need to do, and put a spacer in it, because I can't get the lock nut to undo for the bearings. Because I need one side is nice and loose. I can do one side of the axle, but the other side won't budge. And I tried using my cone spanner, which is laying on the floor actually, and it just rung off. So there ain't no way that's going to change. It's still a good wheel. I can still use it on another bike, but it's just not going to work on this bike. So I'm going to have to come up with another idea. I know I've got a wheel downstairs, and I think I've got a wheel up here. It's a rather dirty, rusty, manky wheel, but I do believe it's straight, and I do believe it still spins fine, so I think I'll dig that. I'm not going to dig it out tonight. Well, not now, it's too late. It's nearly 11 o'clock, maybe 10 o'clock. nearly 10 o'clock. A bit too late to go banging around in the outside cupboard for that, so I'll finish this bike off tomorrow. But I fitted a V-brake to the front now. Because I actually find, when I'm on a using a bike for towing, V-brakes are a bit easier to adjust and maintain when I need to. But yeah, you can see I've got those big chunky forks in there. But the steering feels a hell of a lot better now. And I've nicked the brake levers and V-brakes off of the turd, as I like to call it. Because, like I said, I was just going to use it as a parts bike, and ideally I want to get this one. Oh, what's going on there? Oh, bother. I'm going to have to let that front tyre down because the tyre's popped off the rim. If I've got anything I can just poke in there. I don't want that to go off bang overnight. I wondered what locked the wheel up. I don't know if you can see that in there, but... That's all right. Again, I can't really use the foot pump on the floor at this time of night either, so I can sort that tomorrow. Sometimes tyres do that, you just have to deflate them, make sure the beading has set into the rim. Yeah, if I actually pump it up again and I make sure I hold that bit, that should lock it into the rim. Some tyres can be a pain for that. Oddly enough, I do come across that little issue quite a lot. Some tyres, no matter what you do, just will not lock into the frame, so I just end up chucking the tyres. So, yeah, a bit of extra weight on the front here as well. I don't think I actually need it, but I think, very small amount of play in there. I may just screw this up a little bit more. Anyway, I found a nicer rear derailleur for the Silver Fox. I may go for the wheels that were in my Claude Butler. I don't know. I have got another disc brake front wheel out on the landing. Is it out on the landing or did I bring it in here? No, I bought it in here. It's here, which is a nice looking wheel, but there's no bearings in it. And I don't know if the bearings, or the hub I should say, is damaged. And where's the cap gone? The dust cap's fallen out of this, so... I do hope that fell out up here. if not, it will be laying outside between here and the shed, so I can find it tomorrow. But yeah, I'm going to take that axle out. I might do that tonight, actually. It's a quiet job. And I just check that the hub isn't damaged. If the hub's not damaged, then I'll just put new bearings in it and use this one. And just throw this one straight into the Silver Fox. Yeah. Then I can just leave the existing back wheel in there. Well, I can't because I've got to change the tyre, but you know what I mean. So, yeah, that's actually I'll leave that job for tomorrow. Actually, no, I won't. I will check it later because... At least that way I'll know if it's worth me fixing it tomorrow or not. Well, that's good. There's a smidge of brake pad rub. But I can't do a lot about that. But other than that, it's free enough for me. Oh, pardon me. What's the time? 9 minutes, is that all? Oh. I might turn the camera off, give it a bit of a charge for the next hour or so. And put the camera back on. I'm not going to get up too much tonight. I might play a bit of GTA. Did I take my pill this evening? I can't remember. No, I don't think I have, so I better do that. Yeah. It's a shame about that wheel. But never mind. I could piss around and change the axle on it and whatnot. But, like I said, I'm pretty certain I've got a tatty but usable wheel in the outside shed. Which I should be able to slip in here. If not, I've got the back wheel on the turd. I could put that in there as well. Like I said before, this is going to be towing trailers, so with all the force of it, you know, going side to side like that when it turns, and the chances of the trailer pushing the ass end around, there's a chance that the wheels are going to get run that way and buckled anyway, so. But I don't want to go for decent stuff, you know. I'm not going to go for expensive stuff. Just a bog standard alloy rim like that one in the back will do. I'm not fussed about rusty spokes as long as it bloody works. So, yeah, that's a job for tomorrow. Anyway, what was I saying just before I turned the camera off? I've got that front wheel there, which I'm hoping I can fix. I'll find out later. I've refilled both my grease guns. I've got a rear derailleur for the Silver Fox. And before anyone actually asks, if you're wondering why I would stick that in over using the pair of wheels from my Claude Butler, the old pair, it's because the old pair is not a matching pair anyway, so either way it's not going to be a matching pair of wheels on the Silver Fox. So that would just save me a bit of hassle if I can get that fixed. I can just chuck that one in there. Let's try to think what else. I haven't looked for any gear shifters yet. In fact, I think I used the better ones on here. And I can't be asked to change them. So I'll have a look to see what I've got. I don't really want to buy new ones. It's either that or I just leave those gear shifters on there temporarily and see what I can find down the dump. I'm sure something will come in. Could go down there tomorrow, actually, if I can get over to Mum's. Don't know, might ask her later, or tomorrow, or whenever. Right, is that 10 minutes? Oh, 13 minutes. Oops. Oh well, close enough. Right. I did have to put a new set of batteries in my bicycle light over there. So I noticed earlier, not only was it getting a bit dim, still perfectly usable, but it was getting noticeably dim. It was also slightly flickering as well. So I just brought it up here and I slung some JCB batteries in it. We'll see how long they go. Well, at least the battery load light is off now. But the battery load light has been on for weeks. Oh, that reminds me, I need to spread this side open because it seems a bit too closed. And the only way I can get a wheel in is to smash it with a hammer. So I need to get, ideally I need to get something in there to open the drop out a little bit. I think that's got a bit squished. It doesn't look it though. But yeah, it was a pain in the ass to get the wheel out. I want to use that as a hammer just to tap on the axle. Right, I'm going to put this on charge. I'm going to disappear. I'm just going to strip the axle out of that because it won't take 5 minutes. And just check the hub, so I'll be back later. Well, I haven't charged the camera yet, so I'm going to hope it lasts for this little bit. I was just talking about cars to a friend of mine. I mean, this afternoon, me and Mum were having a little discussion about modern cars, and I just can't get excited over a modern car, because they all follow, especially over here in Europe, a similar sort of baseline in the design, you know, which can make it difficult to tell them apart, especially at distance. And, you know, they all come, regardless of manufacture, whether it's a Ford, a Renault, a Citroen, a Peugeot, they all come with the same basic standard features. They all offer the same extra features, near enough. The engines might vary a little bit, but you know what I mean. Electric windows, better looking interiors and whatnot, you know, as you go up through the models, bloody blah blah. But on the outside and whatnot, they all look the same to me. You know, your everyday affordable car. And that got me thinking that that's probably why I like classic cars a lot more. You know, a Ford Escort didn't look like anything else on the market. It had its own unique style and design, same as any other classic car, you know, the Rover P6, the Ford Cortina, the Vauxhall Viva, and any other classic car, you know, they all had their own unique look. Nowadays, they don't. They just have that unique shit look to me. And to be honest, I've been in various cars. I've been in French cars, I've been in British cars, I've been in all sorts of cars. Like Mum's Toyota. The quality, you know, when you feel the plastic of the dashboard and whatnot, and the quality of the fabric on the chairs and the carpet, it doesn't matter what the manufacturer is, Peugeot, Citroen, Toyota, Nissan, Mitsubishi, it all feels the same to me. Which again, you know, takes the uniqueness away from them. That's just it to me. There is nothing unique about them. They're all just the same. Same basic design under the bonnet. You know, front wheel drive with everything sitting on a bloody subframe. If you could change a drive shaft on one car, you could probably do it on them all. In fact, I was watching someone on YouTube this morning, Retro Restore is his channel. And he's... I haven't watched all the videos yet. Oh, and the battery's gonna die, so... But yeah, I haven't watched all these videos yet, but it just looks like changing things on a car is the easy part. It's just a lot of hard work. Taking things off just to get to things. Anyway, I'm gonna turn the camera off and charge it. Right. That's just taken over 2 hours to charge this bloody camera. Not sure why, unless it's because of such a low current output from USB. But that probably is actually because I have a number of things I've charged from USB and they do seem to take far too long. Anyway, I've had the axle out of this. In fact, I can remove it. Bearings are fine this side. Helps if I actually show what I'm talking about, you know, dumbass. Anyway, the other side of the hub is fine. What I've got to do is retrace my steps in the morning and see if I can find the dust cover and put in some new bearings and some new grease. And job should be good. I think caged bearings will fit, but if not, I'll have to put single or loose in, I should say, not single. I'll get that job. I'll get that sorted and I can start on the doodad hoojima flippy thing. Silver Fox. There we go. Ooh, excuse me. I'm not so back wheel out for that piece of junk down there. Somewhere. And so that's not gonna work. Just got one of them LCD screens that look all funny when you try and look at it from an angle. Doesn't quite work. Right. Well, I'm going to bugger off to Mum's tomorrow. I don't know what time. I'm going to get up and get breakfast and drop her a message on the wonderful world of Facebook. Even she's read all that squit about my friend's shed, and she's just like, haven't they got anything better to do? She's right, though. You know? People just seem to whinge about the most trivial of things. And I think the only reason those that live right near my friend are only whinging because they're frightened it will affect the value of their house. I mean, really, is that all people can worry about these days? Is fucking money. I'm glad they've got the fucking house, you know. I wish I could afford a bloody house. Would I think the same way as them? The bollocks. I'm not worried about a fucking shed in someone's garden. Right, anyway. I suppose I'll do this over here. As I haven't got any room anywhere else. Mum came up today to borrow the PC. Only because she'd left the house in such a hurry this morning. She came out with the wrong bank card. So she had to sort of flick it across from one account to the other. And of course, do all that online, which is just as well, because her bank isn't... we don't have a bank for her, no Halifax in town. Used to, but they closed it. Anyway, I thought, I might as well have a look at this before I bugger off to bed. Now, the idea is, you don't permanently wire it in, so it's got this with a switch on it. And the idea is, you screw it up to the wall, probably near a socket, preferably. I can't believe they actually had to test this. This is brand spanking new, never used, and they had to test it. Whatever. I wouldn't have bothered personally. Right. Anyway, this section goes on the wall. You can see the two screw holes there, right? Very simple. You know, there's no permanent wiring required. I'm not sure what that bracket's for. I've got four brackets here as well. I've got the bloody wiring diagram plug. Don't need that. I know how to do it, but if you don't, then it's a good idea to keep it. It's just protective card. Now, what you do, there's a selection of these in here. There's actually another one in there, which I may go get the other one. I may go get it. You've got all these various sheets. You see, there's just a plain one there. Plain white one. It's nice to see all these are actually packed with a bit of like tissue paper between them. There's this red one. It's like a red filter that you can put on it. Then there's this one. with just some random wavy slots cut into it. And of course, the last one. Get off. It's just full of dots. It's just a decorative wall light. That's all it is. So you've got all of these, a few of these with different patterns. And then of course you've got the red filter if you want it to glow red, or you've got the blank plain white one if you just want a plain basic light on the wall. Got a bit of this Perspex sheet stuff here, I suppose you could put on. Look at those holes line up. No, it's because the one underneath is bent dipstick. You know. Several different combinations. And there's actually screws in that, so what is that? TYFT. Come from IKEA. German, or is it Swedish? Somewhere in Europe IKEA come from. I can't remember off the top of my head though. Yeah. Yeah, and it looks like you can contact IKEA for some help as well. There's a lot of different languages in here as well. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 different languages. But the instructions look like they're pictures, so that's pretty much a universal language. Yep, it just shows you how to fit these brackets which hold the screens on, or shades on. That's what these bits are for. I was actually thinking of hanging this in the bedroom. I don't think I've got anywhere I can hang it in here, as I put it up by the TV. Yeah, maybe I'll zip across and get the other one and pop it up by the TV behind me. And one in the bedroom. Then I can get like a little LED light bulb Thursday or something, or at some point. And oh, I see what this is for. Where is it? It's so you can corner mount this light as well. You'd mount that between the two walls in the corner. You know, like corner over there, for example. And you can then mount the light to this. So you can mount it in a corner. Ah. That's a pretty smart idea. Simple enough to put on the wall. Two screws. That's it. Two screws. And then you put your choice of filters and decorative bit on top. Now, I suppose if you could get this plastic sheeting in different colours, you could. You know, make your own coloured filters, I suppose. Unless you could buy these. You might be able to buy them separately. Yeah, I just thought before I disappeared to bed, I'd just show you the light I got. I will probably put the red filter on. In fact, I'll probably play around and see what I prefer. I think a low wattage... sitting on the box. Tit. I think something like just a soft glowing bulb, LED bulb, like those ones up there. Well, not quite those ones because they're too big, but you know what I mean. They're only 1.2 watt, them bulbs. So something like that, that will fit in that fitting. The only problem is Lidl's don't have any now. They did. They've sold out. They've only got the GU10s. Because, whoops. Pan too fast for the camera. Didn't like it. You know, they had several different sort of fitments of those 1.2 watt LEDs. They did GU10, they did those, they did candle bulbs with the smaller Edison screw fitting, which is what this takes. Oops. well, it's got a fairly long lead. What I might do, because I wanted to take it down and move it anyway, I might move this with my handful of cassette tapes on it and put it there, because it's hanging right above that socket, so I can plug it in easily down there. And then the bedroom, I don't know, I haven't decided yet. I might. I don't know. Let's go have a look and see if we can find somewhere to put it. I definitely want one in here though. Actually, I think it would be nice if I could get it right between those shelves, right there. Right in here. And I would just have to drill a hole through that to drop the cable through. You know, I could make a hole just close to the edge. If I get the light up first so I know where the cable's going to hang, and then I can figure out where I want the shelf and just mark on the shelf where the hole's got to be. That'll be the easiest solution. Yeah, I like that idea. I like that idea a lot. Right in the middle, I think that would look quite nice up there. You ain't really got anywhere else to put it, unless I decided to like stick it on the end of the wall over here. It's another option, maybe, I don't know. Yeah, it's this sort of, ouch. Forgot I got that cut in my finger. That screw fitting I need. Ain't gonna cost a lot. But if I put like a 1.2 watt LED in there, I don't know, maybe Lidl's will get some more in at some point. I hope so. Oh, a hell of a breeze coming through here. Yeah, I'm gonna take a stop at the dump as well. When I go over to Mum's, I might get lucky. Might get lucky. Oh, there could be just a pile of shit up there. I know Biggles said that Sunday there was quite a few standing there, but no doubt by tomorrow they'll all be gone and there won't be nothing there apart from a pile of crap. I just know what my luck's like. But as I say, you never know unless you go and look. Well, it doesn't matter what box I'd put on the floor, you'd sit in it, wouldn't you? Even if it was far too small, you'd try to sit in it. Actually, I know you would, because I've seen you do it. Don't be cat. I wonder if he wants a bit of food. I am. I'm going to top his dish up before I go to bed. Because I am getting pissed off of him bloody meowing at me at sort of 4, 5, 6 o'clock in the friggin' morning wanting food. And licking my hair. That's a trick of his. If I don't respond to the meowing, he'll get up on the bed and he'll start licking my hair. Don't ya? You're lucky I love you to bits. Yes, I do. Yes, Daddy does. Yeah, I've just realised I haven't watched a Vlog and Life video for the last couple of days. I'll have to play catch up. I'll play catch up tomorrow night, I think. Oh, bloody hell. Why? Why is it little cuts like that always hurt so much? Especially when you catch them. Or get salt or vinegar or ketchup or anything in them. I haven't done that yet. Yet, touch wood. I don't want to talk that up, because it's going to sting like a bitch if I do. Oh. I don't think my handlebars are in there straight. I may have to just twist the stem. Actually, I don't think I did the stem up properly anyway. I've got to worry about it. Well, I could just say bollocks to it and just throw the original buckled wheel back in, but it's a bit pointless really, isn't it? Sort of defeats the object. Right. I've just had a thought. That I've made a huge mess on the floor. Let's get the bag off of this. It's just so simple to make. If you're good at metalwork, or you had the metalworking tools, like a workshop or something, you could probably fabricate things like this yourself. Because it is just literally... I mean, look at it. Let me just get the cable up out here, out of the way. Look at this. Look. It is just a bent sheet of metal with a couple of tabs cut in here. A little extra long one on here for the lamp holder. And a few holes drilled into it. Maximum 40 watt. Well, I'm not going to put 40 watt in there. I suppose that would be for normal filament blobs. I haven't got normal filament blobs. Get this little baggy hero. I might as well get the brackets stuck on here. I've got to say, I hope I didn't fling all the bloody screws everywhere doing that. No, but I didn't open the bag either. Where's my box cutter? I have to use that. What did you do at 1:30 in the morning? I talked about lights. There's a surprise. I'm talking about lights. Alright. So there's the four brackets. Should have four screws to fit them. Yeah. If you wonder what that noise is in the background, ask the cat. You found a new toy. He's never been interested in any toy mice or anything like that. Apart from the laser pointer, which is up on the shelf behind you. Right. So I've got to get these on properly. Ah. Okay. Simple enough. Two going in one direction, two going in the other. Right, so they've got to go on. I'm going to slide these under the metal tab first. Now, have I got a magnetic screwdriver? Is that magnetic? It is. Woo! Here's one I made earlier. Get all that lined up, get the screw in, like so. There's one. So they basically go on like that, underneath that tab. Now I need to find the opposite one. Yeah, there is. There's two that go in one direction and two that go in the other. So I don't need my box cutter anymore, but I do need a screw, which I've put very cleverly underneath the black light. Alright, so stick it through there. You put a screw on the end of the screwdriver. And we stick the frickin' screw in the frickin' hole like this. I don't know. That wasn't really any accent. I was meant to be Scottish. That's what I was meant to start off as. But that just sort of went into something completely weird. Alright, so. It's just the same procedure at the top here. And it's just got these little nuts on the end to hold the... filters on. I've just done this round the wrong flipping way. Should have put this in here first, because it doesn't want to go in. There we go. Did I get it? Yeah, it did. Right, the last one. Get hold of the screw. Well, can't put all the screens on because I've got to put it on the wall first. I'm definitely not doing that at 1:30 in the morning. I think my neighbours would kill me. But yeah, that's what it looks like with the four brackets on there to hold the filters. Just like that, then you just take these nuts off, slide the filters on, and then put the nuts back on to hold them in place. And I suppose it'll, I don't think you'll need a spanner, I think you can get away with doing them finger tight, to be honest. Let me just see what it looks like quickly with one on there. I don't think it's got instructions in here. There's quite a lot of thread though. Let's just have a quick consultation of the manual. Yeah, it's only showing to put like the red one on. If you want, of course, you don't have to. Okay, so that it will only go on. Ooh. It's going to be quite a tight fit. Well, it's not that one either. Okay, so it appears they'll only go on one way. The only thing is, you've got to find that way. Why won't two on, but for some obscure reason, the others won't fit on. And the manual is quite a see that I've gone wrong anywhere, but they just, you know, without doing any bending. Ah, that's what you got to do. You got to bend the bloody things. There we go. That's what it's going to look like with the red filter on. Not very fetching. And then just stick that one on. Now the nuts are being a pain in the bloody backside.
One little show in just a second. I'll just get these nuts on. Get them nuts into place. I just think I've got to take all this part again to put it on the wall. But I think I'll do that till Wednesday. Unless I sit and do it in the morning, if I've got time. Why won't that bastard go on there? That's because it's going on as far as it'll go. But there here we go, there's the... shit. Clang! Right, grab you, there we go. I'm not sure if that's actually meant to be anything specific, but... what else have we got? We've got those lines. Now I'll just try each one and, see which I like the best. I just need a bulb for it now. Don't want stupid old CFL bulbs. You can just see the red in the background. Yeah, methinks I may have to go grab the other one. If it hasn't been grabbed already. I doubt it, they've had these in there for about 2 weeks. I've noticed they have dropped the price of them. That was £4, and when I went to get these ones, it was £2. £4 to £2. Don't think people actually realised what they were. Although the other box has been open so you can see the contents. Which I'll just have to make sure I put back together. I think for breakfast I'll have some bocadillo sausages. Sausage rolls, rather. Good old sausage rolls. Right. I can't remember if I've got an adjustable in Mum's car or not, so I'm gonna take one with me, just in case. Got bored and gone to your chair now. My monitor is clicking off far too quick, I'm sure. Anyway, I think it's time for me to disappear off to bed. Because I'm getting tired. It must be because I just tripped over the handlebar of my bike. Just had another idea, but I don't know how I'd pull it off. I could put that up there. Get both of them and have one either side of that. But, yeah, I'm not quite sure. Well, actually, I could, because there's a socket there. And there's a socket outlet there. So I could. I could. That ain't actually a bad idea. I don't know how well they, you know, what they're going to look like up there, but... I know the power cords are going to be dangling down, but I've got cables dangling everywhere over here anyway, so it wouldn't make much bloody difference. Yeah. I think that's what I'm going to do. Maybe. Although I think they're a bit high to see up there, personally. Find some way to put it. I think over there. One. I'm not sure where I'll put the other one yet, but I'll find somewhere. Anyway, I'm going to go to bed. So I can get up somewhat early, go get breakfast, and hopefully go to Mum's somewhat early. So, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And, I'm doing it again with the thumb, aren't I? No idea why I do that. Anyway, talk to you all again soon. Bye.